At first, I want to talk with some introduction. We want to study some Simpact manifold. To study Simpact manifold, everybody know the Riemann surface. Riemann surface. Topologically, completely we know, but algebraic geometry, still many people work on Riemann surface. So, using this Riemann surface, we want to study the Simpact manifold. So, we to study Simpact manifold. Inside Simpact manifold, we want to study two-dimensional sub-manifold. Topologically, two-dimensional sub-manifold element of this two-dimensional integral homology class. So, if a class is in two-dimensional homology class, then two representing this homology class, we consider the two-n dimension manifold from Riemann surface to usually you want to use the almost complex structure. Every Riemann surface is a Kähler manifold, so has a complex structure. Then some almost complex structure is here, and almost complex structure is here. So to stem representing this homology class, we consider the some map from Riemann surface to the Simpact manifold. Then usually we gather some genus and some mark point. Then you also this representing this is a homology class A. This U is not only smooth map. J homology map. So you usually called this is not integrable. So usually called pseudo homology map representing A. We mark point. We have some mark point G1 to Gn, G to the K. We can consider this. So for each homology class, we can consider the moduli space of M, some genus G, mark point K, and representing A, this JJ homology map. Then this is usually not compact. So we want to compactify. So we consider stable JJ holomorphic map. So you see the, we know the genus G. If you go to the some limit, then this Riemann surface get some singularity, like also can get some bubble like this, limit. Energy concentrate some point and decreasing, then that kind of thing. All this reduce from Riemann surface to the Simpact map. Then we consider stable concept which man in consider at first, this one. This, we want to study this globe within modular space, representing this homology class. Then, we can define some globe within invariant. Also, we can consider some evaluation map to the mark point. Then we have a mark point U and G1 and GK like this, go to the U G1 to the U G G to the K like this. This is evaluation map from modular space to the original case power of our 2n, this the case power of m. Then we can introduce the Gromov-Witten invariant from some m to the gk like this. M to the K to the usually we consider. This is not usually some oval structure either. So to the Q like this. This Gromov-Witten invariant is defined like this. If this is defined like this, this is definition of from this Gromov-Witten A to the full pair of evaluation map. Alpha k. If this dimension is ugly, then we can compute, otherwise zero. Like this, Gromov-Witten invariant. Roughly I explain what is Gromov-Witten invariant like this. This is a number of J holomorphic curve, J holomorphic map representing A passing through alpha 1 to alpha k. If you consider Poincaré duality, this is a homology class. In the homology class, passing through all points, because another interpretation is like this. We can consider some evaluation map, image of all this to the Poincaré dual of alpha. Intersection number, just like this. This point alpha is stand for this alpha 1 to alpha k. From this Gromov-Witten invariant, we can define another multiplication of cohomology, so-called quantum multiplication. If alpha is inside some cohomology, beta is another cohomology element, like this element is cohomology degree L, degree is some L1, L2. Then we define the quantum multiplication using the Gromov-Witten invariant we defined already, like this formally. A is a two-dimensional homology class, integral homology class. like this. This is some degree, Q is a degree 2N, some auxiliary variable. C1A is a first term class evaluate at A. A is a two-dimensional homology class. What is this? This is exactly alpha star beta. This number is defined by, this is inside in cohomology L1 plus L2 minus 2 C2 the A1 minus 2 C1A in, I already said this is has a degree 2N. So total degree is like this. 2 C1A inside in here.
What's the capital N?
Yeah, I will explain. N is a minimal Chern number, so-called minimal Chern number. H2MGC1 is some N to the, like this. This number, minimal Chern number, so-called. Then this is evaluate on gamma. Gamma is a homology class H L1 plus L2 minus 2 C1A to the M inside here. So same degree we can evaluate. This is a definition defined by Gromov-Witten invariant. Some alpha, beta, Poincaré dual of this. Like this. So this multiplication is very important. New multiplication. Using the Gromov-Witten invariant, we can define like this. Many people work on here. In quantum cohomology, this is associativity. This is why if everybody defined some binomial some multiplication closed, this is closed in the quantum cohomology. Then at first we should check this operation is associative, set by associativity or not. This associative is very important. In quantum cohomology, from this operation, we can define some covariant derivative. That covariant derivative connection is pure if and only if this multiplication is associative, and also satisfy integrability condition, so-called WDPB equation, Witten, Dubovin, Perrinde equation. That many physicists, also geometer topologists work on this. So I want to study the long time. I studied the symplectic manifold, and inside there are some finite group act from the quotient space and the equivalent version of Gromov-Witten invariant, equivalent version of quantum cohomology, and I relate that you see the symmetric product is very standard finite group action in there. If M is a symplectic manifold or Kähler manifold, then E product in my note of actually X like this. This K, M copy of X, full factor of M copy, then we denote this M. You can naturally give us some simplex structure and Keras structure from X, we can. Also, we can give action SN, symmetric group of like this, M, from X1 to XN, we can act like this. Just permutation of this element, like this. Many elliptic geometry work on this subject. From this, we can, from this action, we can get this orbit space. We denote M prime. This is N's symmetric product of X. We denote this. You see, very standard example. I will explain in my talk. If X is a standard P1, CP1, complex projective line, sphere, then you see X to the N product of N, N's copy of X, then we know this is very topologically and geometrically, this is very, we know that from the complex projective line. Then M prime, M to the, from, we divide by symmetric group action. This is CPM. You know the standard example of algebraic geometry, CPN. From this, this is a simple example of our work. Some projection is here. And on this part, you get a quantum cohomology and chromo-Witten invariant, we can work. Everybody work on this. Chromo-Witten invariant and the quantum cohomology, some relation. Many people work in here. On this, we can consider the SN invariant some part on the upside. What is the relation? The SN invariant, some quantum cohomology, Chromo-Witten invariant, and this one, we can relate. So this is a very interesting part. Many people work, not only as two.
M prime is not smooth, right?
This is smooth, CPM.
No,
not smooth. It's an orbipole. But we can give us the almost complex structure, also some symmetric. We can gather from this Keras manifold, we can gather some, formally, we can give some complex structure here, formally. Because this all symmetric group element is permute. So we can give almost complex structure. Almost complex structure on X is invariant on this. So you will see the my talk. This kind of thing I will give. So I already mentioned in the proceeding, this result will appear two journals, International Journal of Geometric Method in Modern Physics, that journal, Russian. I already mentioned the introduction. So So I will skip introduction. So X, omega X, JX is a two-dimensional closed Kähler manifold. More generally, you can work on the symplectic manifold. M is a product of X, K copies product. We can define some Kähler form and almost complex structure on this product space using this Kähler form and almost complex structure. The natural action is here. Our space is K copies of X, product of K copies of X. So I already mentioned like this, act. Then also this SN act Kähler manifold, preserve Kähler form and almost complex structure. And what is the fixed point? Fixed point is very important. You see the equivalent version, to consider equivalent version. There are many elements in SK. You can get a fixed point. What kind of fixed point we get? I explain this. Some give an example. So I first, M is the product of K copies of X, and the symmetric group SN act on canonically on M. The orbit space, this is already mentioned, this is not smooth. Get some singularity is there. It is called case or the symmetric product of X, this definition. Then you can get the Euler characteristic of M prime. M prime, Euler characteristic M prime is, we can get from the fixed point set I already mentioned. This is a Lobsius fixed point theorem that Euler characteristic of symmetric product is like this. You can get Euler characteristic of symmetric product. Then McDonald's formula for the generating series of Euler characteristic of this. All infinite sum of Euler characteristic of symmetric product defined like this. Get this kind. Very beautiful. You see the from all, this is very different symmetric product. But all symmetric products Euler characteristic defined like this. 1 minus t over minus Euler character of x. Not inside in here, only x depends on x, like this. This is a McDonald's formula for the generating series of the Euler characteristic, this. As an example, you see the, already I mentioned, x is p1, s2, then m is k copies, a product of k copies of p1, then M prime symmetric product is PK. Then we know the all know the Euler characters of PK. PK is K plus 1. You know the all even dimension is 1, odd dimension is 0. So Euler character is K plus 1. This is by the Lobsius fixed point theorem. You can gather this. You can check also. What is a fixed point? You can check. The McDonald's formula says like this. PK is Euler characteristic. We know all this is, you know the P1 is Euler characteristic 2. So 1 minus T minus 2 power is like this. You expand like this. Then this is M prime S equal 1, then this. You know the S2. M equal 2. Then this. M equal to K is K plus 1, like this. So Euler characteristic come, all Euler characteristic of the symmetric product space come from the original our manifold, from X. this maxon. The other thing, there are many generating systems you can get some result. I'll skip this one. Another one, Krug, already mentioned, but Krug-Witten modular space. We considered closed means compact without boundary, two-dimensional Kera manifold with a Kera form is this, or a complex structure. Then K product of K copies from M, we denote M. Then Kera form and we can define. For simplicity, we assume X is simply connective. Then two-dimensional homology class, just sum of this. If simply connected, if X is not simply connected, then we can get a two-dimensional homology class from the one-dimensional homology class product. You will see the Kenny theorem. So pi is some projection. Then we always consider the Q's coefficient because you see the symmetrization invariant together invariant SK invariant homology class averaging like this. Is the definition averaging. So this coefficient is in general not integer. So we consider integer coefficient is Q like this. Then we get this diagram. From invariant part to the, this is commute. Then this is in general Q coefficient is not integer coefficient. This is not just one-to-one, but in Q coefficient, this is isomorphism. Topology, we know that. So in cohomology class, also same thing. Image is like this. This in cohomology defined like this, same formula, projection. So we get this kind of diagram. Alpha and alpha prime is a canonical, canonical product. This is a projection map from projection map to this one. This one is in integer coefficient. This diagram is commute but not isomorphism. Commute but injective. But you see the rational coefficient, then commute and isomorphism. This is a general canonical. Yeah, but you just simply sit assumption that this is true, always true. But to get some
theorem is true without simplification.
Yeah, okay. That's true. Yeah, we to simplify the, our calculation. I just assume the simply connected. Yeah, they're always true. This. Also, symmetric is act on the already mentioned. This is a modular space. M to A is we just simplify. In generally, big quantum cohomology and small quantum cohomology. Just consider small quantum cohomology. So just consider three Mach point from Riemann surface to the M. There is a stable J holomorphic map representing some two-dimensional homology class, M. This is modular space, stable chain holomorphic map representing A from the, this is not smooth. Sometimes get some singularity. Arithmetic genus is zero, our case. Reduce rational curve with three Mach points to the Kera manifold M. Then the modular space is a compact, stratified space in general with dimension, highest stratified, pi space is a dimension like this. From the index theory, we can compute. In some sense, inside there are some LT operator is there. So we can compute the dimension of this. Also, we consider some element. This is some calculation is needed, some calculation, but from one element, we get this kind of thing. Inside symmetric invariant homology class. Then for that homology class, the Madurai space has a SK action, just composition like this, permutation. So we get two computers, we get a quite complicated diagram is here. I will omit. Also, I mentioned some usually already Professor Kim's mentioned that this is not smooth manifold, orbifold, but we can get in algebraic geometry, this is standard process. The we can give a direct from the direct image, we can study holomorphic function on M and holomorphic section, holomorphic vector bundle. Many people do like using this step. For this invariant homology class, we get some Madurai space. The this is a mark point, always a mark point inside some diagonal. That Madurai invariant, SK invariant Madurai space, and in the OB spaces, Madurai space are homeomorphic. We prove from the theorem, we can get the same diffeomorphic. So in the straight piecewise diffeomorphic, the dimension is same. We can get using the Atiyah single index theorem, we can compute dimension of this thing. And the Gromov-Witten, I will go the Gromov-Witten invariant. So same construction. M is a product of K copies of 2N dimensional Kera manifold. Gromov-Witten invariant we consider, and SK invariant, Gromov-Witten invariant, something like we can define like this. Already I mentioned, but I repeat, we have only three Mach points for small quantum multiplication. We define like this from here and evaluate this. Then we can get some rational number, like the E is an evaluation map defined like this. Also, we can SK invariant, Gromov-Witten invariant, same, just this is Gromov-Witten invariant, this is SK invariant part is also SK act on the Madurai space, so we can evaluate like this. This is SK invariant, Gromov-Witten invariant. Also, SK invariant, Gromov-Witten invariant relative to some diagonal to relate to the quotient space. We consider relative to the diagonal defined like this. Madurai space is different. Also, we get this kind of commutative diagram already mentioned. Then theorem is said the globe with an invariant, relative globe with an invariant, SK invariant is relative globe with an invariant is same thing in the downstairs globe with an invariant. And this is quite good. We define the Gromov-Witten invariant, so we define the quantum multiplication. After that, we can get some quantum cohomology. So mentioned this is n is you already asked me n is defined like this, so called minimal Chern number. This capital letter should be, and we defined alpha star beta is like this. Q is degree 2n auxiliary variable. The cohomology class is inside here because this whole degree plus whole degree is sum is k plus, should be k plus l. This is multiplication. So this is defined like this. We use the Gromov-Witten invariant is here. So this is formal definition. Yeah. Then we define the quantum cohomology like this. Q is some 2n degree auxiliary variable in the tensor product of Q. If this is integer coefficient, then integer coefficient tensor, this. Then this. This is a result of the many and the concept. This multiplication is distributive on each part of addition and skew symmetry. This is, you know, the co-product is skew symmetry and associativity. And this quantum cohomology SK invariant part is downstairs is isomorphic. This is another quite good result. So we can get some relation upside and downside like this. Relation is this. To get some relation, we get some motivation is here. Modular space of dimension is we can compute. This modular space of dimension is from M is a product of K copies of X. So modular space is dimension is same. You can. And actually we can prove the this modular space is each part of modular space product is homeomorphic. And Gromov-Witten invariant, quite natural and good relation. So quantum cohomology is skipped as proof, but the quantum cohomology of a product is each quantum cohomology, each factor's quantum cohomology is tensor product, like a Koenig's theorem. You know the Koenig's theorem, torsion part and its free part is there, but if we use the field coefficient, always this is a Koenig's theorem in some sense. Also, I will give some already mentioned, but I will give some example. On X, M is K copies of CP1, a product of K copies of CP1. This is inclusion, this is projection, we get some relation. Then some invariant part is here. Also, some gather some relation, we get a fixed point like this. Or also from our previous theorem, you can get a, this is usual cohomology is like this in Q coefficient Q A1 to the AK. Our X is P1, so generator is A1. A1 square is 0, like this. But quantum cohomology of this is like this. Invariant part. And the quotient part, already mentioned, the symmetric product of P1 is Pn, so like this. Pk, in our k copies. So in quantum cohomology, yes. Product of quantum cohomology is like this. And quantum cohomology of SK invariant part is like this. We can compute. A is A1 plus AK, generator of each factor. A to the k plus 1 power is Q, like this. And this symmetric part of quantum cohomology is down in the downstairs. Symmetric product quantum cohomology is isomorphic. And I'll give another example, but I'll skip this one. I have 2 minutes. Also, another paper, I get some result, recent result, generating series of Kronwitten invariant. M is this, then M prime is already mentioned, CPN is here. We consider the moduli space of this, M to the rational curve, 0 is genus 0, rational curve with K Mach point. And two-dimensional homology class is n times S2 standard generator. Then moduli space dimension, you can compute like this, 2n k. And we can define some Gromov-Witten invariant defined like this. All other element is 0. Only one element is remain, non-zero element. So we get a generating series. If k is m plus 3, then dimension, this moduli space dimension is like this. And homology in the downstairs, symmetric products homology is just tensor product of m plus 3 copies of m. And Gromov-Witten invariant, we can compute direct. By hand, we can compute like this. M plus 3 combination 5, 4 to the m minus 4th power m minus 2 factor like this. So for this Gromov-Witten invariant, we can get m for the m prime, we can get a generating series like this. Exactly, my time is over. Thank you.